Hi folks, here we are once again. The something on the wing. Something. I don't know if that's something on the wing, but there's definitely something in the water. Right. Oh, God. Where are we? Okay, I wanted to put those safe, and we're gonna go down. Okay, it seems that the zombie pigmen are finally okay with our existence. Ooh, ice. Abomedia is recording fine. We're just gonna put these things safe, and then we're gonna go down. We're starting to run out here. Okay. While we're up there, I need to do some maths. I need to work out how much we've got in the way of blobby stuff. We have 11 slime balls. That's not gonna be enough. Nowhere near it. No way, Jose. No way. The other thing I think I'm going to do is use the red brick all the way around, and we'll see what happens. For now, we have a little bit more glass, we have a bit more this, a bit more that. Let's just take another thingy who's me, what's it? Although I think we have enough. There's one down there. Also going to need some torches, which we don't have. So we're going to need another few of those. Oh, what the heck? Oh, God. Cobblestone. And there's none in here, which means I'm going to need to go down and get it. Let's just close that. Oh, what a day. What a day. What a day. And it hasn't even started yet. Cobblestone. Let's just grab some. And, ooh, that lot's come up nicely. Still don't know what I'm going to do. We're going to need some more iron as well. So let's have a look. We've captured that. We've got the light of the mines. So we now have to light mines, get iron. We also want to build what do we call it? Farm? Blaze farm? What else do we want to do? Get I was just looking at them. What the hell was it that I was looking at? Blobs of stuff. blobby stuff? Get blobby stuff, yeah. Blobby stuff. That'll do. I'll know what I mean. Maybe. So, what we need to do is... Let's grab some of those. We're going to turn the rest of them into... We don't have any fuel. Duh. Let's nab some charcoal. Put that back. wood products. Let's just take a crafting table down to the nether. And another few chests. I've forgotten what's in there. So we have 36. That's going to be enough to do the job. Let's go. Wibble, wibble. Wobble, wobble. Wibble, wibble, wobble. I know. Oh, there's already one chest here with something in it. So let's just put another chest there. And, yeah, let's just put a crafting table down there. That'll do us. Okay, we have the beginnings down here. What is it with Minecraft creatures, eh? They could use an awful lot of throat lozenges. Now, I worked out from watching the video that I need to be 12 below the spawner, which was 67, so I need to be down at 55. And it does actually sound like there's a blaze spawner a lot closer to home. Sorry, 55, yeah. Right, that's 55. Now we need to be at minus 274. Let's just put some extra stuff up here. Where's the last torch there? So put another torch here. This isn't really for sight. It's just in case it has an effect on spawn. Which I'm not too sure of, but there you go. So we need to crack on until we're minus 274. Ooh, spooky music. A bit more spook than that. Mind you, the sound of zombie pigmen is dangerous enough. Yes, I can hear them. We're not far off now. Bode well. Right, we are now underneath the spawner. Quite far underneath the spawner. 12. I don't think it bodes well that we're in that position and I could hear a blaze. But either way, we actually need to get up on top now, and we need to tame, or rather build a cage around that spawner. Now, I've watched the video and obviously it's dealing with an 8x8. We are now dealing with a 9x9, which does slightly bugger things up a little, but I'm sure that we can overcome. So we will ditch these, ditch that as well. One thing I want to bring down is actually something else. I wanted to bring something else down. Bucket of lava. That's what I wanted to bring. Well, let's go and get one. Let's go get a bucket of lava. Lava palava. Tools, buckets. I'm sure we can find some lava out here in the Nether. You reckon? Unfortunately, a lot of that stuff is dangerous to get at. But we shall try. We shall do our level best. Right, I'm just going to stay alert for zombie pigmen being angry, just in case, because you never know. quite a few down there. None of them appear to be perturbed by our presence. The sound of the blazes did not encourage me. Okay, we want that stone, we want that glass. Because we have some work to do. Now. This is thus the first section. Drat. That was wrong. Now we need to get on top and complete the top section. Drat. I've buggered that up, haven't I? Yes. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes. This is the top section of the spawner, and I'm out of stone. Bugger it! I am out of stone. Can you frigging believe this? I can. Do I have any more in the chest? Is the question, and I don't think I do. Yes, I do. Is that going to be enough to finish this build? I don't know. There is a... I hear the deep, deep breath. Of something in the vicinity. Now in his video, he did put an actual inner lip on here. I don't want to do that, and I have a reason. Oh no, for fuck's sake, oh no. And I'm out of glass. For fuck's sake, I am out of glass. Okay, we need some more glass. That is basically almost first stage complete. Nearly. I can see you, Scully. I can see, and he can see me. Oh shit, here we go. Battle onwards! Quick dispatch. A very quick dispatch. Wahahaha. We are relatively still high up. Let's just kill some of this fire. I didn't like fire, especially when I potentially have to run. Fire. Da 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 da. No, that's all flowing stuff. We can't get a source block out of that. Okay, let's play this safe and go back and get some from the overworld. The overworld. Because we need more glass anyway. Yes, the Avermedia is safely recording. I know. I am potentially being a bit backwards with that, but... Ooh, hang on a minute. Let's get these nethers out of here. Wait. Nether or not, here I come. Haha! Nether! Sorry. Okay. That's some more nether stuff. And we shall finish the last of the cooked mutton. And ice. No! No ice! Straight out! That's cool! Now let's just put that safe. So we need more glass. While we're here, let us just finish the gravel issue. Got to look up designs for the skull that I want to put at the back. Okay, let's pick up all this stuff that I've just dropped. And while we're here, oh no, I can't. Haha! It's now right the way down the bottom. Oh dear. Nice. I wonder what else I can do here. Maybe put something on the wall, some climbers or something. Yeah, that might be an idea. I'm gonna have to go to the swamp anyway. So yeah, maybe we can do that. Diorite stone. And we'll take those stone bricks out of that. Because we're gonna need them. And more when it comes to the build. Oh, of course, I put them in a separate chest, didn't I? Safe in here. More glass. We don't have any there, but we do have some there. 26 glass. Is that going to do the job? I think so. And we also need the bucket of lava. Oh boy. Yeah, that online stuff about the zombies really helped. Incidentally, in case you're wondering, even though it's going to be... I'm probably going to mention it in another video. I must be about... possibly about 2 weeks behind by the time you learn about the broadband fate. The fate of my broadband. Mwaha. Sorry. I'm over to PlusNet. They've done some tweaks to the line in terms of gain, but the dropouts still remain, and that's despite doing everything that I've done at home. So next thing is they're going to have to put it up to the faults team. Obviously I've got to wait another day or two for these results to be solid. I've got no reason to believe that they won't be. Bats. Oh, hello, Pigman. Right, here we are. Okay. I wanted to put some more chests. At least one more chest, sort of closer to the action, if that makes any sense. So I don't have to risk coming out of the project in order to continue to work on it. I'm very nervous now. Very, very nervous. Sound spooky. Anything could turn against you at a moment's notice. Yeah, as such, we'll take these chests up. And yes, I'm just noticing another screen that basically tells me that yes, my internet's gone down again and there's a blaze up there. And there's another one up there. Shit. That must be natural spawn. To be abandoned. What I'm going to do is put an extra layer in here. Now this extra layer is not in his video, but what I want to do, if I can do it, do I have the reach from here? No, I don't. Gonna have to build a small bridge out there. And ultimately do this. Now what I'm hoping is that that will generate enough light to prevent spawn when it comes to the inevitable time when I have to actually start taking things to pieces. What I'm going to do is put a couple of chests here and put some stone and working stuff in there. Right. So when I come back, there's already tons upon tons of stone there. That's not going to be enough to finish the project, probably. And we're going to need a lot of comparators. We'll need some stone slabs as well. We're going to need some electronics and bits and pieces. But I want to make sure that I come back here with enough to finish the job. Oh yeah, definitely need enough to finish the job. So, we are now getting there. We're now getting there. So hopefully at some point we will have the ability to get down and be able to get there without having to take the surface route and be able to build without being open to attack. That's going to take a little while yet. I may have to come in with some stone stairs just to lay down to make it easier. Okay, what do we have in here? Not much. A couple of chests, they can stay there. We'll keep some dirt in, we'll drop some cobblestone off. I think we'll leave it at that. So, what next? Next is going to be a... Hello. A trip out to get some slime. We've got 11, so we need at least another 20. We can leave the glass behind. We've got some nethers to drop off. Whoops, no. Let's get rid of the andesite. That's the nethers. We can drop the wood products. We have torches. We're going to take the rotten flesh with us, because that'll be a useful bargaining thing with villagers. We're just going for a bit of a bust-up, really. So, our weapons, we will swap those out. Incidentally, when it comes time to run the spawner itself, we can use the gold swords on the blazes that spawn in the spawner, so we can use those later. We're going to need food. We'll take some cooked mutton. My systems are telling me that, you know, I'm not sure about this. I may put another ring of andesite under there. Andesite? Whatever this is. Granite. I don't know. Good grief. Gotta do something about this. I'm going to put this safe. We're starting to build up some, so we're going to get some, hopefully some emeralds, ender pearls. Now that's one of the other things. We are currently about 1,000 out. I'm hoping that we're not going to be too far from a major thingy-me. What's it, doodad? Yeah, I think I'll swap those out. Yep, got it. Right. I've only got 6 stone, which means that 2 I haven't picked up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, there they are. I got them now. I could actually potentially put a contrast in there of white. You know, I think I'll do that and see how it looks. looks better. Okay. So we want to kick the diorite, drop the stone, drop the granite. We have food. We have a decent weapon. Now we just need to swap out for some decent armor. In fact, I think what we'll do is sometimes I hate how this works. Thank you. I think we'll put this armor on the emergency armor list. Oh, in fact, we might as well have a sleep while we're at it. I'm gonna have to do something with this bed structure as well. You know, two bed does look better than one, but now it's just looking a bit stupid against that wall of three. Here we go again. Right, so we have armor, we have everything we need, I think, to go hunting. Apart from a brain cell, of course, because I should have come out here and gone down there. This, I think, will become the emergency armory. Yeah, we'll put some weapons in the furnaces there, right. Tally-ho, south we go. Right, onwards and southwards. Is that a skeleton I see before me? No, it isn't, it's a tree. Duh. Ah, more zombie flesh. That'll help with the trade. I think I did detail in another video how I actually tried to... What did I try to do? I tried to do something. Yeah, translate the engine up to 1.9. However, the mods aren't quite up to it. So as a consequence, this world is still 1.8.9. Wabbit. Hello, Wabbit. You know, there have been some changes in the world in general, and we've gone from a straightforward line between corporate and customer to an environment where they're sort of mixed, and Bouyang sort of was across that bridge. It was a commercial production enterprise which has and relies on a strong consumer element, for want of a better phrase. As a result, people were doing things and little tributes to who otherwise would be considered ordinary people and customers in the eyes of the traditional corporate, you know, have had things put in the game in their honour, which is quite stunning, really. And it's all signifying for me this mash, this merge between consumer and corporate. there's a vast blurring of lines. Something else crossed my mind concerning this sort of thing, which is that so many of us now are having issues with our art. I mean, there's just so much around now. There's so much photography, so much digital art, so much digital music that is produced by people who have day jobs, and they don't actually need to see an income from their work. Pardon me. There are obviously limits to such work, but I was wondering, how are such things going to survive in the future if so much of us can get our music, arts, input satisfied by non-commercial entities? Then what's that going to do for or to the commercial entities? What does that do to the artists who are reliant on a commercial income? What is that going to do? What is the meaning of all this? I thought that, well, because basically, with me, for example, the writing side, there's only so much effort I can put behind that. And at the minute, the commute that I'm doing, all the rest of that lot, blah, blah, play the violins, yes, I know, means that there's only so much effort and energy that I can put behind my work. And I think that at some point we could potentially see a return of the what is it called? Not donor. Well, patron. The traditional patron. I mean, not the kind of patron that that we see via systems like Patreon. I mean, my problem with Patreon is that it's not a solid income. You know, it's things can come and go. People can. I think we've seen it on social media quite frequently and scaringly frequently, that it only takes one social gaffe, one foot wrong, or indeed one thing that your audience, your patrons, don't agree with, something that you think is a practical joke but society thinks otherwise. You know, there's little room for apology in this system. People will just abandon you. And if you're reliant on a Patreon income, that is going to hurt. That could potentially mean the death of your art. Oi, you, come here. Ah, 38. Nine gold for an emerald. You know, I don't currently need that many emeralds. Oh, he's bubbling up. Emerald for redstone, emerald for lapis. I don't think so. If that was the other way round, I'd take you up on that offer. But, yeah. Like an idiot, I should actually have come out with some wood, because I think we need a chest. Last thing I want to do is drop these emeralds. There should be an area south of here, which I think is I heard that skeleton, which is swamp. Just for the heck of it, we will grab ourselves some wood. One tree is all it's going to take. Oh, hello. An egg. No, thank you. The chickenator is running perfectly fine. That's not it over there, is it? I think it was actually just north of the other village, which means we need to cross this one. I think it was just north of the sand village, potentially over there. Okay, we're gonna get our feet wet. Doing, doing. Yeah, back to what I was talking about. Yeah, I wouldn't like to rely on Patreon as an income. Especially not when it comes to art, because quite honestly, from what I've seen from the art world, much of it is designed actually to pull us out of the groove, for want of a better word. To a degree, it has to shock, because its job, as I see it personally, is to nudge us and almost make us uncomfortable, you know? Make us see the things that we didn't want to see. Oek. This is a bit far out, and I don't have a bed. I didn't think really, because in order to get much of what we actually need, we need to be in the night anyway, so I didn't think we'd need to sleep, but we are a bit further out than I thought. So many artistic endeavours do actually require us to shock, or not shock too much, if you know what I mean. Not, well, different people are shocked to different degrees by different things, you know? That's part of the thing. Oh, hello, Enter Pratt. Come here. I'll have you. Yay. I love you. It was the fire. There's another Enderman there, but we've got creatures all over here now, and I'm being shot at. Fuck. We need to get safe. Yeah, zombies and all the rest of that crap. Tell me about it. Go on. Damn it, I got set on fire by my own zombie. Zombie hugs. Come on, come get some. No twit, close the bloody door. Honest to goodness. I think there was a house in this village that had books, and I might have left the crafting table intact. It saved me having to make one, but stuff it. Okay, so when we get to where we're going, we can lay down some stuff. Because we're going to need to be there multiple nights. There's no way on this planet, on this digital dangerous planet, that we're going to be we're going to be able to get everything that we need in one night. We're talking more than 20 sticky thingy, what's it's you know, there's just no way that that's gonna happen. Yeah, so the some of the purpose of art is to actually shock us out of our ruts, give us something else to think about, widen our perspectives, and in order to do that, it's got to, some of it has to do it in unpleasant ways. I mean, some of it can be really awe-inspiring, but yeah, there's a chunk of art that, you know, sometimes has to shock, and sometimes it feels totally, you know, like, but it's also a battle for attention, you know. In order for artists to get attention, they've sometimes got to do some really wacko stuff. You know, shock, pretty much, in order to just get noticed. Whether you think that's fair or unfair, who knows? But, yeah. Look, will you guys just can it a little? Or screw the zombies, I'll kill ya. Oh, shit. I can't stand the knocking. Knock it off. Yeah. I think that says as much about our society as it does about art in general, really. In that before we take advantage, notice of some stuff, it actually has to shock to a horrific degree these days before we'll even give us a second glance. Which I don't think is fair to society as a whole. But what do I know? What do I know? Oh, well, you can it with that bloody tabletop already. Yeah. I think that says quite a bit about our society in general, really. And the state of affairs of things. How the hell did I get onto this subject? Oh yes, patronism. So yeah, I think that we're going to have to go back, or we'll see a return to some of the patron side of things. God, another bloody zombie at the door. Just get out of it. Sorry, pal. I think you're dead. He could have had good traits as well. Who knows? Raw pork chop. String. Coal. Make that coke and you got a deal. Oh, it's a hisser. It's a real hisser out there. That's going to make it difficult when it comes daylight. There's another one over there. We're going to have to make a run for it. Look, just get out of the way, will you? I just need to get out there. Just go forth and light. Ah, shit! That wasn't meant to happen. Sorry, guys. Yeah, I know. Bad one on my part. I screwed it. What do we have here? Not much. Sand. Sandstone? Yeah. My bad. Sorry, guys. Shit. And again. More sandstone down there. No, I didn't mean to drop that there. Screw it. And it's still mostly sand. Ugh. Was my own bloody stupid fault. I suppose I'm gonna have to come back at some point and make good. Oh, God. And now it's daybreak. Sounds downstairs. Yeah, that was a bit of a bore set, wasn't it? Oh, pal, just click off. Yep, that was what we call in the game a cock up. Go on. Go forth. Go forth and die. Okay. Somewhere to the south here. To the south of this village that I've so helpfully destroyed. Should be I'm sure it wasn't this far out, you know. I'm almost sure it wasn't this far out. Sandstone, just a bit more, and I think I'll have enough to repair the damage. Ah, whoops. Shouldn't take too much more. That should be enough, I think. But ultimately, we need this swamp. Where the hell is the swamp? Hopefully, it's just over this rise. It looks like it might be. Yes, it is. Beautiful. Okay, so we're going to make this our home. Our home from Swampy Home. We're going to ditch our ill-gotten gains here. Ditch that there, just in case we need it. We're going to surround it by torches. At some point, if we have to do this on a regular basis, I'll turn this into a far more permanent sort of home, if that makes sense. But for now, we'll just light the heck out of it. Boom, 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 boom. We can leave the torches, we need the bones. Right, not long now before night time. And I wonder if we can actually get some of this stuff. No. I think we might actually have to create some shears to get it. Shears. Iron. We have a little bit of time, so why don't we actually just get some iron? Find a quick hole, nip down it, for which we'll need the torches, and see if we can find a couple of easy blocks of iron. A It's just at this sort of time that you find out that nothing of the sort exists where you are. Time upon time, you're running around, tripping over holes in the ground that want to swallow you whole. And when you actually want one of the bleeders, can you find one? No, that would be too easy, wouldn't it? Yeah. Ooh, lava. Cows. Moo cows. Yeah, moo, I know. Horses. There are actually some horses closer to base. But, yeah. Looks like we're going to have a nighttime encounter in the swamp before we actually find a potential mine to fall down. Ooh, there's a mine. Okay, there's a dead end. Just my bleeding luck. Gotta read up on horses yet. Aha, another mine. This one looks more promising. All we need really is a couple of pieces of iron. Not a hope. Oh, for freaking heck. But what we can do is a furnace, and I've just realized that we saw some coal in that last one. That's enough for a furnace. Let's go get that coal. Oh, yeah, we've got quite a bit of time left. We might actually have to kill a few animals as well for some food. Oh, do we actually? Yes, we get cooked pork chop. Thanks to this sword. It pre-cooks it. Gorgeous. Now, where was that hole? That hole in the ground that promised us coal? Wasn't there. I thought it might have been a slime balls, that's what they are. But apparently not, it was just another cow. Where was this coal? I think the other thing I want to do is mine a little more. Mine a little more stone for another stone pickaxe, which means we're going to need trees at some point. Oh no, we have enough trees, I think, in our little base to do the job. There's our little base. Yeah. A furnace as well for smelting iron. So we could actually just use wood. We could chop down some trees and do it that way, but night is almost upon us. Let us prepare for battle. This could hurt. To that degree, we'll put those safe because we're not going to need them. And let's rock. Come on, bring us your worst. Give us some slimes. Unfortunately, this looks like a new moon, so we're unlikely to see any this night. Slimies. Slimy whiny. Come on, slime. There's a skeleton. Doink. Goodbye, skeleton. The other thing that limits our time out here is also going to be the strength of the sword, which will need to be replenished. I'm listening. I'm listening for slimes. Not hearing any. But I can hear my mobile phone. Let's just move those out of the way, shall we? Yes. Zombie over there. Couple of them. Grrr. Goodbye, zombie. And a rat. Bloody hell, fire. He vanished before I could get to him. We are under attack. Oh, you picked up a shovel. Lucky you. Creeper. Hoping I haven't seen him. No, he hasn't seen me. Woohoo! Bonus. Still no slimes. Being a new moon, I didn't think we'd get many. Let's head into trouble. Quick attack. Ouch. Yay. The real sods around here are actually witches. They are the buggers. They're the ones that can really ruin your day. There was a gentle thud, but I think that was just a cow. Ender Pratt, come on, can you see me? Can you see me? Can you see me, Enderman? Yes, you can. You're mad. You're mad and you're mine. Kaboom, 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 kaboom! Where's that mad Enderman? Come on, man. Where are you? You're mad at me, I know it. So come get some. Come on, guys. Once there was an Enderman. Enderman is chicken. Enderman is chicken. Okay. You running move. Sword is already down to 50%. Ow, that hurt. Wait, what am I, a pincushion? No, but you're dead. Another Weeper Creeper. The secret for them is a quick kill before they can do anything. Gotta get your creeps in. I think what I'll have to do is mine for quite a bit of iron, enough to make a sword as well as some shears. So we just gotta wait for day now. Boom, 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 boom. Because I don't want to wreck this sword. It's nice, I like it. I don't want to be able to repair it. So once day comes, which is not far away, we need to find some mining territory. Need to find a hole in the ground. I need a hole in the ground like I need a hole in the head. Hello, zombie. Come get some hugs. Yes, yesy. Okay, I'm on fire. That's not good. Ow. Not fair. I was in midair. Enderprat! Come and get some Enderprat! Where'd he go? Oh, not you again. Where'd that Ender idiot go? Come on, Ender one.
Ooh, it's a zombie villager. Does he go with an accent? It's day. It's day. Hurrah!
Where are these Ender idiots? There. There's one. Come on. There he is. There's one of them, anyway. Did I kill him? Don't think so. I think I might have, but he escaped. I don't know. No drops anyway. Okay. Let us continue on the hunt. The hunt for a mine. Do you mind? Don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I do. Yeah, I know. Pretty pathetic, I know. Okay, let's just dump our... Oh, we got a bow. Ah. Would help if we had a pick. I've got some food there, so that's not too much of a problem. I'm wondering whether I should just start mining down. Rather than trying to find an already open shaft. I'm deliberately trying to stay within range of the... Ooh, hello. Yes. Enough for shears and a sword. Ooh. Nice. Now all we need is gold. And there was none. Like an idiot, I should have had that coal when I first saw, clamped my eyes on it. But I didn't. More fool me. Oh, ow, that hurt. Dead end? Yeah, dead end. Coal. Hurrah. Ooh, more iron. That's good luck. Maybe that's not such good luck after all. It was a trap. Yeah, sadly the man who voiced that also passed on recently, so I believe. Oh yes, more coal. More coal, more iron, yet more coal, yet more iron. Oh yeah, we can have some of this. And we can smelt it all on site. Even despite all the troubles that we've had in the Nether, it's amazing how quickly we've managed to regain a reasonable amount of XP. Okay. Is that a skeleton I hear? Probably is. But This will be more than we need for this endeavor. And by the time we're finished with this, it should be closing on nighttime. Okay. We have our needs met, so it's back to base. Sword at the ready. Yeah, I really think that art is going to be more luck than anything to actually get known out there. And I think the only way to get known, short of selling your soul, is to actually produce something that wows people. And that ain't easy. That ain't easy by a long shot. Okay, now this sword I don't mind losing, if you know what I mean. Shears. Now let's see if we can shear us some of this stuff. I think that once we've got some. Yes. We have it. Once you have some of this, it grows like poxy, apparently. I'm also taking some of the bush oak leaves. I think I'll put some on the outside of the castle to see how it looks. Obviously it's going to have to grow. You know, just something to age it a bit, you know? Let's just take this tree to pieces. That's an interesting one. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I hit it at the top, it all collapses, we only get the one. Whereas if I hit it at the bottom, get more for our money. Ooh, I actually picked up grass. I wonder if I can pick up the other stuff as well. The taller grass and the stuff that's in the desert. And if I can, what use is it? Recipes, perhaps? Fortunately, we're not very far away from a desert. No, it just comes off as grass. Yes, we can get dead bush. Dead bush, Kate Bush, it's all a lot of bush. We'll pick it up anyway. The good thing about the vines is that they grow, so we can start cultivating them. There to cultivate them, however, I'm not sure what they actually grow on. Not far now before night time. Back to base. Hurry back to base. Where did I pick up the cobblestone? Oh, must have been somewhere. Okay, somewhere in here is some dead piggy wiggy. Pork chop. Iron armor is in good standing. We can ditch the torches. In fact, I wonder if I light the place up. So I think, if I recall correctly, that slime spawn is not light dependent. So if I light the place to pieces, we should get stand a better chance of slime spawn, and not much chance of anything else, hopefully. That is the hope. That is the plan. It didn't work, did it? Hello, trouble. Ay. We quit with the arrows already. Ooh, we got another bow. Come on, we need some slime spawn around here. And I'm nearly out of torches. Whoops. I can hear some slime. Where is it? I was almost sure I could hear a slime. Apparently not. Okay, we're currently half moon, so the next one should be full moon, and we should have a really good chance of some slime spawning. We're gonna wander over here. No slimes. Yes, I know, Spid, you want me. You want a piece of me, don't you? Tough. Okay. Okay, I am now out of torches. If this experiment actually works, and we do get some slimes spawning in here during the next night period, then we should actually be okay. We'll actually have a reasonable recipe for spawning slimes. I just light the heck out of the place so nothing else can spawn. I know. Look, pal, I know a good pharmacist. Let me give you his card. I've got his details written right here on this sword. He can sort out that throat of yours, no problem. There is another way of dealing with your rough throat, you know. I could always slit it for you. Yeah! There you go. How's that? Free of charge. Oh, hell. Wow. That was unexpected. Should have known better. There was a song about that, wasn't there? I should have known better than to lie to one as beautiful as you. I should have known better. Nearly day. Just gotta hang in there a few moments more. There's no Enderman anyone in sight. Oh yeah, there's one over there. Come on, pal. Can you see me? Do I make you angry? Do I make you mad? Yes. Come on. Enderman, your pathfinding is shit. Damn it. Sangre, another one. Ooh, Enderman took out that thingy. What's it? Yes, we have an Ender Pearl. At last. Bit more string, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little bit of the other. And we've angered this one. Come on. Use your pathfinding, you idiot. I can't come over there because I'll get my arse shot to pieces. Thank you. Come on. Another Ender Pearl. Just gotta survive this a little longer. Oh, bugger. Where did that come from? I don't know. Run! Run away! They're dying. Okay. I think we're pretty much safe for the time being. So what I'm going to do is ditch this stuff. Another bow. More gunpowder. Gonna make just a few more torches. Put that iron away. Okay, ladies and gentlefolk, what I'm gonna do is call this a break and go off and do something which isn't Minecraft related. And I'll come back and pick this up, because the next night will be a full moon. And we all know what happens on full moons. Ow!